so this is what I did. I went on LinkedIn, typed in data scientist in India, and it shows about 2,500 results. This is a couple of months back. I'm sure it must have increased now. A couple of months back, there were about 2,500 jobs, which is insane, right? If you were to look at some other fields, I don't think you would find as many jobs as these. It's an incredible time to be looking for a job in data science in India. And I think most of you are lucky that you have such a strong support system with UpGrad and everyone else trying to help you do that. Okay, so now we know there are a lot of jobs in data science, but do we know what they are actually looking for? So this is something that is confusing to a lot of people because there are a lot of different substreams in data science, and which substream is the most suitable one for me? Which one should I specialize in? And in fact, there is something called the generalist data scientist. Am I a generalist data scientist? Am I a computer vision data scientist? We'll go through that. We have one sample job advertisement. This is, again, a few months old, but the job descriptions are pretty useful to go through. So the first one says you should have good knowledge of statistics and machine learning techniques. Does everyone here have that? Okay, you've ticked the first bullet point. Should be able to sift through data, there are some spelling mistakes, and extract the underlying patterns and insights which could be applied to solve the problem or add value. Should have good problem solving skills. This is key. You should have good problem solving skills. Should have working knowledge or experience working with tools such as R or MATLAB. How many of you here know MATLAB? This is a very rare opportunity. I can go apply there because a lot of jobs need MATLAB. Most often than not, either Python or R skills will be sufficient for you to find a good job. Should be able to convert high-level goals into set of use cases or KPIs to be added to the solution to solve customer problem. This is, again, a very useful point. What it means to say is that you should have the ability to take a business problem and convert it to a technical problem, into a problem which can solve some KPIs for the business users, right? This is a key skill that you will have as a data scientist. I'm sorry, we'll take questions after I finish, okay? Yeah, you can keep your questions and we'll take questions afterwards. Should be able to prepare data sets, tune params, select set of attributes, etc. to ensure the model trained solves the problem. So basically you should be able to do hyperparameter optimization and other things that are required for you to build a good model, okay? So these are the job descriptions of a data scientist at ICLECT. What are your responsibilities? You will have to select features, build and optimize classifiers using machine learning techniques. You will have to do data mining using state-of-the-art methods, extending companies' data with third-party sources of information when needed, enhancing data collection procedures to include information that is relevant for building analytics systems, processing, cleaning, and verifying the integrity of data used for analysis. Doing ad hoc, so basically if you go through this, doing ad hoc analysis and presenting results in a clear manner, creating automated anomaly detection systems and constant tracking of its performance. So if you go through this responsibilities, you'll get to know that this is a job which actually requires you to do a lot of data gathering, data collection, data storage. In other words, it may be a job which is well suited for a data engineer. Right? I mean, that's what they do. But since companies don't know what a data scientist is or what a data engineer is, they would put up a job posting. So it becomes really important for you to go through the job posting. So for example, here, if you go through the responsibilities, I think you would have to be doing a lot of work which a data engineer would do. So again, one of the key tips to actually getting a good job would be sift through or read through the job posting thoroughly. And understand what they expect and what is the problem even the company is trying to solve. In fact, some of the companies don't even know what they want. And this is your responsibility to understand what they want and if it's something that fits in with your skill sets. All right? Now, for the most important subheading, which is the skills and qualifications they expect out of you. This is great. Excellent understanding of machine learning techniques and algorithms, such as classification, regression, random forest, CRF, SVM, clustering, CNN, neural networks, etc., etc. Enter buzzword there, right? You should be able to understand everything that is there in the world. You should understand why President Obama was president, etc. Yeah, so this is how, unfortunately, today's skills and qualification requirements are. Again, if you go further, experience with common data science toolkits such as, this is brilliant, right? Experience with common data science toolkits such as R, MATLAB, Python, related, etc. So they want you to be fluent in R, MATLAB, Python, everything. For what? I don't understand. But so again, the problem with this is the skills and qualifications mentioned in a job description almost always are more than what you can do. So what the point I'm trying to make is that if you meet even 60 to 70% of the skills and qualification of a job, go ahead and apply. Because they themselves don't know some of the times what they want, or some of the times they know, but they want to put, so these are, again, HR tactics. They want to put all the buzzwords in there because it might get some candidate that they wouldn't have got, right? So yeah, just be careful on that. Just make sure that you, if you're all, so this was something that I faced initially as well, right? I used to think, hey, I'm not meeting about 100% of these requirements. Should I even apply? Go ahead and apply if you're meeting even 60 to 70% of the requirements. Because a lot of them are, like I said, buzzword fillers, right? Experience with data visualization tools such as D3JS, ggplot, etc. See, for example, if you were to be experienced with D3JS, you should know JavaScript, right? It's a JavaScript library. There's no JavaScript mentioned nowhere in the entire job posting, but they want you to be fluent with D3JS. To know D3JS well, you should know JavaScript well. And there's no requirement for JavaScript. So my point being, they just want you to do data visualization. You might be able to do it with Python's matplotlib or seaborn or any other library or R's ggplot2, anything, right? So try and understand what they're looking for. It might not be like, okay, I don't know D3JS, I'm not going to apply to this. So just be careful on that front. Proficiency in using query languages such as R, SQL, etc. Basically, that's the gist. Be careful when you're reading the skills and qualification. Apply even if you meet 60 to 70% of the qualifications. And about the responsibilities, read through them, try and understand what the company is looking for. Is it a data engineer? Is it a data scientist? What kind of a data scientist, et cetera.